Parish of Redeemed Christian Church of God, Oklahoma City. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Daddy in the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And today is the first day of July. Our topic today is the bread of life indeed. Before we continue, I'd like to say a word of prayer. Father, we thank you, O God, for another opportunity to hear from you. We ask, O God, that you open our eyes to behold wondrous things out of your love, for Christ's sake. Amen. So today, the first day of July, our topic is the bread of life. Indeed, and our memory verse is taken from the book of John, chapter 6, verse 55. It reads, "Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day." I'll take that again. "Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day." And our text is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 14, verse 22 to 24. It reads, "And as they did eat, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body.' And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank it." Verse 24. "And he said unto them, 'This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many.'" Praise God. So this morning, we're looking at the bread of life, and we know that the bread of life is our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus offered his body to his disciples, and by extension to us, his present day apostle. An invitation to a holy communion service is an invitation to come and partake in the life of the life giver. Jesus is the life giver, and when we eat of his body, when we drink of his blood, we are eating eternal life. We're eating divine health. The body of Jesus was broken for us. And so, when we partake in the Lord's Supper, we are eating Jesus' body, which is meat indeed, according to the book of John, chapter 6, verse 48 to 50. "Whoever eats his body has eternal life." What is eternal life? Eternal life is the kind of life that God lives. Eternal life is the kind of life that Jesus lives. A life that cannot be taken by gone, by accident, a life that is free of sickness and infirmity, a life that is free of death. And when we eat of the body of Jesus, when we drink of his blood, we are eating divine health, we are eating eternal life, we're eating a life that cannot be harmed by evil. Praise the Lord. So that this morning is telling us to eat. We should know what we're eating. When we eat of the body of Jesus, when we drink of his blood, we should know that we are eating divine health. We should not do it like a ritual or a routine. We should eat it with knowledge and understanding. Praise the Lord. So the Lord cannot pay such a great price only for us to remain in the congregation of the dead. The book of John, chapter 10, verse 10 says, "The thief cometh not but for to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But the Lord Jesus is saying that I have come that you may have life, and have it more abundantly." One of the benefits of eating the body of Jesus, one of the benefits of drinking his blood, is to have abundant life, is to have life in abundance. I advise us to sometimes take the body of Jesus and drink his blood, even at home. Sometimes when you feel sick, pray for yourself, take the body, drink the blood, give it to your children as well. Don't wait until you come to church. You have the power to do that. Jesus Christ has given us that power. So long as you're born again, so long as you're giving your life to Jesus, you can do that. You can bless it and take it. And of course, when you take it with understanding, when you take it with knowledge, it will work for you. So one of the benefits is abundant life. And another benefit is the Holy Communion meal positively affects our body, our soul, and our spirit. So that is telling us that Holy Communion, when you take it, it positively affects your body, your spirit man, and your soul. Another benefit is when you partake of the life-giving meal comprising the broken body of Jesus Christ, if value is added to your life. Value is added to your life. You walk in the supernatural. You walk like an extraordinary person. Praise the Lord. Then another benefit is, no matter how empty or meaningless life may have seemed, partaking of the Holy Communion meal gives you new life. It gives you new life. The old man is taken away. Your inner man is strengthened. Your spiritual life is strengthened. Praise the Lord. So, ensuring that you can have a better life, go further and achieve greater things. The Holy Communion can help you achieve greater things. It can open unto you divine ideas. It can open unto you divine direction. So the Holy Communion is embedded in it a lot of benefits. And this morning, as we partake of the Holy Communion, as we eat of the body of Jesus and the blood of Jesus, I pray that we'll have more abundant life in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. What is the prerequisite for taking the Holy Communion? The Holy Communion is not for everybody. It is for people that have given their life to our Lord Jesus Christ. If a sinner takes or partakes of the blood of Jesus and the body of Jesus, that person is on his or her way to death. So you cannot take the Holy Communion if you are not born again. So one of the prerequisites is to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. If thou shalt confess with your mouth and believe with your heart, the Lord Jesus, he will be saved. Praise God. So another prerequisite is begin to live by the commandments of the one who paid the supreme price for the salvation of your soul. Not just giving your life to Jesus. The second prerequisite is to live the commandments. What are the commandments? Thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not cheat. A lot of people just give their life to Christ and they take back their life. When you commit sin, when you do the things that does not glorify God, you're taking back your life that you have given to Jesus. And I urge us this morning that as we give our life to Jesus, we should walk our salvation with fear and trembling. We should walk out our salvation with fear and trembling. We should not give room for the devil. We should try as much as possible to ask the Holy Spirit to help us to live a life of emulation, a life that glorifies God, to live out the commandments that the Lord has given us. Praise the Lord. Then another prerequisite is, you must, however, be careful not to partake of this meal unworthily. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 27 to 29 enlightens us on how to take the Holy Communion, not to take it unworthily. Is there any sin? Is there any character impediment? Is there any weight that easily besets you? This morning, our daddy is urging us to lay it at the feet of Jesus, so that when we take of the body of Jesus, it will not be a curse unto us, rather it will be a blessing unto us. The Bible says that our daddy went further to tell us that this is why many are weak and sickly in the congregation, because they take it unworthily. In order not to partake of the meal unworthily, you must do a self-examination and ensure that you do not have a lifestyle of sexual immorality and other sin. May the Lord help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So that gave us a prayer point, and prayer point is, Father, please let the broken body and the blood of Jesus Christ avail for me in all areas of my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'd like us to make that a prayer. Lord, we pray this morning, even as we've heard your word, Lord, we pray that the blood of Jesus will cleanse us from every character impediment, from every sin, from everything that will make us not to be worthy to take of your body and your blood. Help us, O God, and as we take of your body and your blood, we receive healing, we receive divine health, we receive eternal life, we receive life in abundance, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you tomorrow. Have a good day.